So, welcome to yet another session with the star in your child. Today's topic is diet and autism. So, with me, we have Dr. M.V. Ali. She's an associate professor with the educational qualification of MPhil and PhD. She was a researcher advisor in nutrition and dietetics of Bharatidasan University, Trichinopoly. She was a referee to a journal of autism and development. And she's also a diet consultant to special schools in Trichy district. Talking about her achievements and research will take the entire time. So without much ado, we'll get straight with the session. Ma'am, please explain to us. First of all, welcome, ma'am.
Thank you.
So please explain to us the relationship between diet and autism.
Okay, thank you. Autism is a pervasive developmental disorder as explained by the physicians. And the classical features of autism are the children have impairments in social interaction, communication, and also imagination. Autism is one of the first ranked developmental disorder, and it is increasing in epidemic proportion in these days. This particular disorder has a male predominance, and when the children are getting proper therapy, when there is early intervention, and when there are multimodal therapies, there is a possibility of increasing the quality of life of these children. So in this context, I would like to explain the relationship between nutrition, diet, and its implication in autism management. Can I share my screen?
Please, please do, ma'am.
Bhakti, you have to allow me.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Done.
Thank you. Just a few seconds.
Not a problem. Not a problem.
So we shall see about the various aspects of diet and autism. Though the physicians define autism as a pervasive developmental disorder, a researcher, Disroger, he explains or defines autism as a neuro-gastro-immunological disorder, which occurs in the where there is a malfunction in the gene and in the immune system, which means it is manageable. There are various problems faced by the children with autism, and one very specific problem is the problem of malnutrition. So malabsorption is one of a classical problem that is faced by the children with autism. And malabsorption means the food we eat is not properly digested and absorbed, which means there are nutritional deficiencies. They're not getting the required amount of nutrients from the food they consume, and therefore it results in malnutrition. So malabsorption leads to malnutrition in these children. Bhakti?
Yes, ma'am.
If I'm not admitting the participant,
yeah,
then I'm not able to proceed with my slides.
I'm able to add them all, ma'am.
Okay, actually,
because you're the host now, maybe.
Yeah, so it's not allowing me to go to the next slide.
All right. So I take over?
Yes.
But then how will you share your screen, ma'am?
Yeah, I've gone to the next.
Okay, ma'am. You carry on, ma'am.
Is that okay? Yeah.
Yes, ma'am, please.
So digestive problems are many in the children with autism. The digestive problems leads to intestinal disorders, which occurs due to chronic gastrointestinal inflammation. Okay. So this gastrointestinal inflammation leads to impaired absorption of the nutrients, particularly the essential nutrients such as the proteins, vitamins, and minerals. And this causes disruption in the immune function and also the metabolic function. Leaky gut is one of the complaints that is faced by the children with autism. And now what is leaky gut? So there is yeast overgrowth in the gastrointestinal tract of the children with autism. And because of the yeast overgrowth, such as the Candida albicans, it causes what is called as gut dysbiosis, which means an imbalance in the microbiota of the gastrointestinal system. So there are tiny pores in the gastrointestinal system or in the intestinal wall, and these tiny pores cause or it leads to the escape of certain chemicals such as acetaldehyde, alcohol, and opium-like substances. So these chemicals can pass into the brain and cause problems in the physical health, and also it can impair the cognition. So the impact of the digestive problems include diarrhea, stomachache, flatulence, and constipation. So when such problems are present in the children, it obviously leads to problems such as irritability, anger, and challenging behavior. And as we know, these children have several behavioral problems, and atypical behavior is very common among these children. The really, really challenging for the parents. So they eat a very limited diet, and there is difficult behavior during eating, and many of the children have to be fed even when they grow up and they do not sit in a particular place to eat. Some of them like and relish only the junk foods, and many of the children eat untidily. So the feeding behaviors, as I said earlier, are challenging, and the parents have to tackle them. So they insist on rituals. So insisting on ritual is one of the characteristic or a classic behavior of a child with autism. And many of them have trouble in chewing the food. They don't chew the food. And we know that the digestion of the food starts right from chewing. And many of the children hold the food in the mouth, and spitting of the food is there. They throw away the food, and also there is pick up. So one particular problem that we find in children with autism is pica, which is nothing but consuming non-edible items. The non-edible items such as mud, chalk, dirt, crayons, plaster, sometimes wood. So all these things are consumed by these children. So why should this behavior be present in children with autism? It is because of nutritional deficiencies, such as iron or calcium deficiency, or also some of the children consume these because of sensory stimulation. So they are attracted by the color, or they are attracted by the texture of the food, and therefore they consume the food. So one of the most important thing that we have to see in the children with autism is They do not know whether it is edible or inedible. They are not able to discriminate the edible from the inedible food items. Food selectivity is again another problem that are found in the children with autism. As we all know, not alone with the food, with whatever object the children have in hand, we may find the children with autism, they smell it. So here, they are very specific to the taste of the food, the smell of the food, the texture, as well as the appearance of the food. So what are the strategies and how are we going to address the nutritional needs of the children with autism? We have to focus on foods that are fresh, natural, and non-processed to provide wholesome nourishment for the children. So let me here explain about three important strategies. One is consuming a balanced diet. The second one, eliminating the trigger food. And third one, including autism-friendly nutrients. So what is a balanced diet? So all of us might wonder what a balanced diet is. We may have doubt of whether we are consuming a balanced diet or not. Of course, we are consuming a balanced diet, and you may see that in the following slides. The different types of foods, the thousands of foods that we are consuming, are grouped into five basic types based upon the nutrients that are present in them by the Indian Council of Medical Research. The foods, they are grouped as cereals, grains, and the products that are rich in energy, protein, and also vitamins. The second group is the pulses and the legumes, and they are rich in protein. So this is one food which is providing us most of the protein in the diet. The third group is the milk and the milk products, which provide us protein, vitamins, as well as minerals. So let me come to the next. The fourth group are the fruits and the vegetables. So fruits, we know the different types of fruits, and the vegetables, we can classify the vegetables into three types, as green leafy vegetables, as roots and tubers, and also other vegetables. And the fifth group are the fats and the sugars. Fruits and vegetables, they provide us plenty of fiber, vitamins, and minerals, and they are called as the protective food, which protect us from the diseases. And the last group, the fats and the sugars, they provide us fat and energy. So any food that contains all these five food groups, they are called as, or they will form a balanced diet. For example, when I consume idli in the morning, idli and sambar along with coffee, then it contains all the five food groups, and therefore I'm consuming a balanced diet. Or if I'm consuming chapati, dal, a salad, and also coffee or tea or milk, then I'm consuming a balanced diet. The meal that I consume for lunch, the rice, dal, vegetables, and the buttermilk, it is a balanced diet. Therefore, you have to take into consideration that all the five food groups should be used to prepare a meal for a child with autism. Not alone for the child with autism, for anybody, for a normal child, for an adult, for anybody, this is the rule. And here we see the food pyramid. At the base, we have the foods, the grains, which can be consumed adequately. Above that, we have the fruits and the vegetables that has to be consumed liberally. Above this, we have the milk products, the meat, beans, and pulses, which has to be consumed moderately. And at the top of the pyramid, we have the fats and the sugars, which has to be consumed sparingly. So this is the first concept. So you have to, diet can be consumed by including all the five food groups in preparing the meal. The second strategy is to eliminate the trigger foods. So what are the trigger foods? So trigger foods are those that can cause behavioral problems in the children with autism. So the first kind of food that has to be eliminated will be the GFCF, diet, or we have to include the gluten-free, casein-free diet, which means we have to avoid all the foods that contain gluten and casein. So gluten is a protein that is present in wheat and wheat products, and casein is the protein that is present in milk. So what happens when a child consumes casein or gluten? These two proteins are incompletely broken down because they do not contain an enzyme called as peptidase. Because of this incomplete digestion of these two proteins, there are products such as gliadorphin and casomorphin produced. These two chemical compounds, they mimic the opiates and they cause disruption in the biochemical and the neuroregulatory process of the brain. So what happens when casein and gluten are not digested properly? It almost affects all the, I'm just admitting everybody, and therefore I'm a little bit, I'm held up. So when casein and gluten, when they are not broken down properly, it leads to the production of exorphins, and therefore it causes immunological as well as cerebellar changes. So changes in the immune system and changes in the brain function. So it affects the brain as well as the dysfunction of the nervous system. And it at most affects all the functions of the children, as you see here. It affects the memory, the emotions of the child, brain functions, sensation of pain, motor movements, sensitivity, sensation of hunger, thirst, circulatory system, and also in the hormone release. So what should we do in order to achieve this CFGF goal, avoiding gluten and casein? First and foremost, we have to avoid the foods that are prepared from wheat. Wheat and wheat products should be avoided. What are they? They are, you can see the list here, wheat flour, pasta, macaroni, noodles, the biscuits, bread, all the bakery items that we give to our children, they are prepared out of wheat or they are prepared out of the refined wheat flour. So all these should be avoided. So what other cereal contain this gluten? Apart from wheat, oats and rye also contain gluten. But of course, we don't use those cereals and we use mostly wheat. Therefore, avoid all the wheat and wheat products.
I just have to interrupt in between, ma'am.
Yes.
You said we cannot give oats to children as well with autism.
Yes.
So that's completely avoided. It has to be completely avoided. Okay.
Definitely, ma'am. Because oats also contain gluten.
Okay. So anything with gluten, it cannot be eaten by children.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
And the second trigger food are the dairy products. So the dairy products, all the foods that contain milk solids have to be avoided. So all the foods prepared from milk, such as the paneer, the khova, curd, etc., should be avoided by these children. You can see the list here. So all the dairy products have to be avoided, because we have seen what are all the changes that will be produced, negative changes that will be produced in the children when milk is given to them. So we have discussed so far about the gluten-free, casein-free diet, and the next trigger food that has to be eliminated from the diet of the children are the preserved foods. So the preserved foods, in order to improve the shelf life of the food additives are being added to them. What are food additives? Food additives are different types of chemicals that are added to the food to improve their life. So the preserved foods obviously will contain different types of chemicals. So they are added with preservatives, food colors, and food flavors. So all these chemicals in turn will aggravate the atypical behaviors of the children with autism or the abnormal behaviors. And the next, junk food, which is very popular among the children, which most of the children like, also has to be avoided, because junk, the word junk itself says that it is not healthy. The children are not going to get any healthy nutrients from them. So junk foods are to be avoided. Junk foods such as the fried foods, confectionery, soft drinks, and savories have to be avoided because they aggravate the abnormal behaviors. So many a time you would have experienced that you would have given your children a packet of chips or a soft drink or a chocolate so that they behave properly. But at the end of the episode, you would have observed that the behavior would have been more abnormal in the children. So this itself underlines that the junk foods, the preserved foods, foods that contain chemicals have to be avoided for the children with autism. And the stimulants, foods that contain stimulants. Most of our children, the autistic children, are hyperactive, right? So when the children are hyperactive, and when if you're going to give them foods that contain sugar and sweet, it is going to increase their blood glucose level, and in turn, it is going to make them more active. And therefore, you have to avoid the foods that contain sugars, which means all the sweets, toffees, candies should be avoided for the children with autism. Tea and coffee, both of them contain stimulants called as caffeine, which will refresh the brain, right? So these stimulants should be avoided for the children with autism. And also, as I have discussed earlier, the chemical preservatives also act as a stimulant. It aggravates their abnormal behavior, and therefore sugar, tea, coffee, and the foods that contain chemicals should be avoided. So this was our second strategy to avoid the trigger foods. So what do I give to my children? So you can include plenty of autism friendly nutrients. Let us see them one by one. So the beneficial nutrients for children with autism are the omega-3 fatty acids, dimethylglycine, vitamins, minerals, and glutathione. Omega-3 fatty acids are deficient in the autistic children, and it causes disturbances in the functioning of various systems because they are the components of the cell membranes. They are needed for the normal development of the nerve cell and also for the normal development of the RBCs. So let us see the benefits of the omega-3 fatty acids. How is omega-3 fatty acid going to benefit a child with autism? It helps in the behavior control, and you know what are all the type of behaviors exhibited by the children with autism. So it is going to greatly help in controlling the behavior of the children. It will help to improve the learning and will help them to pick up the language skill, reduce hyperactivity, reduce stereotype behaviors, improve attention. It will boost the memory and mood, and it will also enhance the motor skills of the children with autism. So unless I admit, I'm not allowed to go to the next slide.
Oh, I'm really sorry for this, ma'am.
Yeah, so now all of us would wonder, from where are we going to get the omega-3 fatty acid? The omega-3 fatty acids are present in fish, particularly the small type of fish, like salmon. It is present in flax seeds. So here you can see the image of the flax seeds. So this is very rich in omega-3 fatty acids. They are present in walnuts, cod liver oil, olive oil, and also in soya beans. The next food that is going to be beneficial for our children with autism is dimethylglycine. Dimethylglycine, it resembles vitamin B, and it serves as a building block of amino acids, hormones, neurotransmitters, which are chemicals that are required for the function of the nervous system and also for DNA. The benefits of dimethylglycine has been listed here. It improves the cognitive function. It will enhance the speech. So we know how difficult it is for us to train the children in speech. Many of our child are mute. So it helps to enhance the speech. It enhances the immune system. It augments their physical performance, promotes attention span. It helps in getting a better eye contact, which is a very classic feature of the children with autism. And it also reduces the seizures. The foods that are rich in dimethylglycine are brown rice or the red rice, yeast, whole grains, seeds, liver, and the pumpkin seeds. Vitamin B6 and magnesium are again very important in the production of neurotransmitters. So B6 vitamin supplementation can improve the sleep. It can enhance the attention span, improve language. It can control the hyperactivity of the children, promote their overall behavior, and it can also help to develop their speech.
And we'll continue with the session.
Yeah. The foods that are rich in vitamin B6 include meat, fish, vegetables such as spinach, peas and yam, nuts and seeds, whole grains, beans, garlic and banana. So here you can see the foods that are rich in magnesium: fish, nuts, beans, spinach, tomato, pumpkin seeds and the brown rice. Vitamin A, all of us know, is very important for the healthy skin and also for a healthy mucous membrane. It improves the immunity also. So vitamin A helps to improve the eye contact in children with autism. It helps to improve the social skill development, and also it helps to regulate the sleep cycle. All the foods that are yellow, red, and orange in color, and all the green leafy vegetables contain vitamin A. So include as much of vitamin A rich foods as possible in the meal of children with autism. Folic acid is another very important vitamin required for the formation or synthesis of the neurotransmitters. And they are present largely in the green leafy vegetables, legumes, egg, yeast, liver, and the kidney. Glutathione is another important nutrient that is required for children with autism. So this is ultimately required for the detoxification of the system. There are various theories that have been put forth, which says that the detoxification mechanism in the children with autism is impaired. And therefore, consuming glutathione can help in detoxifying the system. The food sources of glutathione include avocado, garlic, egg, spinach, tomatoes, turmeric, legumes, carrot, and cauliflower. So, what are the foods that we have to avoid? So, all the favorite foods of our children. You can see all the favorite foods of our children. So, all these, the soft drinks, the pizzas, the cakes, biscuits, cookies, all the packeted items, all these chocolates, candies, all these have to be avoided, right? As I've explained earlier, you know what are all the consequences behind them, and therefore, please avoid all these foods. And of course, we have plenty of foods that can be included. So among the cereals, except wheat, you can include all the cereals. Rice, the rice products, different types of millets can be included. Pulses, grains, dals, beans, peas can be included. All the vegetables, all the fruits are beneficial, particularly papaya and pineapple, because they contain enzymes which can help in the digestion of these children. All the animal foods can be included. Nuts, no limitation. So when coming to milk, so we are not going to advocate the consumption of cow's milk or the buffalo's milk to these children. However, if you need a substitute, you can give coconut milk, soya milk, tofu, or any casein-free milk that is available commercially. So no restriction to oil or fat, and sugar we are avoiding. So in case the children are very restless, when they are frustrated, you can add a little bit of honey, but this is not, however, recommended. And different types of herbal drinks can be given to these children. So these are all the healthy, suitable foods for the children with autism. All the vegetables, nuts, the rice-based dishes, or the cereal-based dishes. And nutrition therapy can improve the quality of the children with autism, and together we can overcome this problem. So I did my research in the nutritional management of autism, and we developed a food product in the form of cookies incorporating beneficial nutrients that are free from additives, no chemicals, sugar, and this has been patented as well. And so if it is required, you can go to the following mail, and this is being developed by a special school called as the Dolphin Special School, which is located in Trichy. The children who are studying there has taken it up as a vocational program, and they are preparing this. And you can see the for details, you can see the mail, and this also came in the paper, the Cookies for Thought, where the children had prepared these cookies in the newspaper.
Wonderful.
So thank you all.
Thank you so much, ma'am. It was super, super informative. I'm sure I'm not here to jeopardize anyone or any profession, but the knowledge that you have shared today is beyond comparison. And I hope everybody must have, benefited from this session. Thank you very much, ma'am, once again to be here with us and share your knowledge.
Thank you. Thank you, Bhakti. Bhakti, you, the blogger, who has given plenty of motivational lectures, themes, concepts for children with disability. I appreciate your effort in doing such endeavor, and this is one of that. And I am very happy to share my knowledge with all the parents, and I hope the parents would be benefited at least little bit through my knowledge sharing.
Not little bit, ma'am.
If we have any specific questions, can we discuss?
So there was one question related to food that would enhance sleep for children with autism.
Enhance?
Sleep.
Okay.
So they wanted to know if there's any food that they can give which would help them, help the child sleep better at night.
Better at night. So that is the problem. That is the ultimate problem in the children with autism. They are hyperactive, energetic all the time. And we know that they sleep very less. So what we have to do is you have to reduce all the foods that contain all the chemicals that are present. So don't go in for processed foods. Prepare all the foods at home. Give them freshly cooked, freshly prepared foods. Do not add sugar. Do not give sweets at the night. So, and when some kind of activities are given towards the end of the day, towards the evening, when they are involved in physical activity, so that the energy level can come down, and this may enhance their sleep. Apart from that, you see that they get adequate amount of iron. So iron deficiency also can disturb the sleep cycle pattern. So they should get adequate amount of iron, for which you can consume green leafy vegetables or the dry fruits such as dates, figs, etc.
Thank you very much, ma'am. We are running short of time as well. So once again, thank you so much for imparting your knowledge with us. And thank you for sharing this information. I'm sure everybody have benefited from this session, ma'am.
Thank you.